You provide the spirit.
You provide.
Yeah. salama, Die mama ni 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 salama. Kutosha, dhambi zangu kuziosha, kwake Yesu nasimama, Die mama ni salama, Die mama ni salama, Die mama ni salama, damu yake na sadaka, yategemea Mwokozi atanitosha Kwake Yesu nasimama Die mama ni salama Die mama ni salama Die mama ni salama Die mama ni salama
Twakuinua, 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 twakuinua.
Na kwake Yesu nasimama,
ndiye mwamba ni salama, ndiye mwamba ni salama, ndiye mwamba ni salama.
Kwake Mwokozi nasimama,
ndiye mwamba ni salama, ndiye mwamba ni salama, ndiye mwamba ni salama.
Haleluya, haleluya,
haleluya, haleluya, haleluya, haleluya, haleluya, haleluya.
Kwake Yesu nasimama,
ndiye mwamba ni salama, ndiye mwamba ni salama, ndiye mwamba ni salama.
Cha kutumaini sina,
ila damu yake Yesu, ndiye hunipa wokovu. Mawimbi yakinipiga, nguvu zake ndizo nanga.
Kwake Yesu ninasimama,
ndiye mwamba ni salama, ndiye mwamba ni salama, ndiye mwamba ni salama.
Njia yangu iwe ndefu,
yeye hunipa wokovu. Mawimbi yakinipiga, nguvu zake ndizo nanga.
Nikiitwa hukumuni,
rohoni nina amani. Nikivikwa haki yake, sina hofu mbele zake.
Kwake Yesu nasimama,
ndiye mwamba ni salama, ndiye mwamba ni salama, ndiye
Bwana u sehemu yangu, rafiki yangu wewe. We will join together in that hymn as we welcome the family so that we can begin this service.
Pamoja, pamoja na wewe,
pamoja na wewe, katika safari yangu nitatembea na wewe.
Bwana hu sehemu yangu,
rafiki yangu wewe, katika safari yangu nitatembea na wewe.
Pamoja,
pamoja na wewe,
pamoja,
pamoja na wewe, katika safari yangu nitatembea na wewe.
Sikutaka
ili ni heshimiwe, na yani kutema shaka sawa sawa na wewe.
Pamoja,
pamoja na wewe,
pamoja,
pamoja na wewe,
pamoja,
pamoja na wewe. Herini kutema shaka sawa sawa na wewe.
Niongoze safarini
mbele unichukue. Mlango ni wa mbinguni niingie na wewe.
Pamoja,
pamoja na wewe.
Pamoja,
pamoja na wewe. Mlango ni wa mbinguni niingie na wewe.
Pamoja,
pamoja na wewe.
Pamoja,
pamoja na wewe. Mlango ni wa mbinguni niingie na wewe.
Thank you. We remain standing for the opening prayer from Reverend Luke Odhiambo.
Let us pray together. Our God and our Father, we are so grateful that you can give us this moment and opportunity to reflect and celebrate the life of our dad, life of a leader, life of a husband, life of an uncle, life of a friend to many who are here. And we want to pray that, Lord, even as we continue with this service today, that your peace will abound in our hearts and in our minds. We pray that, Lord, you are going to keep this wonderful family peaceful in you, and that, Lord, they will enjoy the comfort and the embrace of the Lord, even as the Lord continues to give them the peace. We thank you because of all of us, O God, and we thank you because of the entire service, that your grace will be abound and that your love will be evident. So bless us and keep us through each and everything that you're going to do in this service. Bless us in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. We can be seated. Thank you so much. We will now invite the senior pastor of this church, Reverend Dr. Stephen Mairuri, to do the welcoming remarks.
Good morning, everybody, and praise the Lord. I want to take this opportunity to welcome you to AIC Milimani as we gather to celebrate the life of Mheshimiwa John Bomet Serut. And I use the word celebrate. I know this time is a time of sorrow and grief for the family, but we do know that those of us who believed in Christ, we know life is beyond the grave. We want to remember the years, the many years that God has given us with him, and we celebrate those years. So on behalf of AIC Milimani, we welcome you, and for convenience, if you're looking for the bathroom or the toilet, for the ladies it's directly down, you go downstairs. Directly for the men, you will have to walk out. It's right on that side. So, karibuni sana na Bwana wabariki. Asante.
Thank you. If we can have the sanitizer, please, Benja. I'll appreciate. Okay. We are going to rise and sing another hymn. It is Well With My Soul. We can be all standing. And after that, I'll be inviting Michaela to do the first reading, Psalm 23, 1 to 6, followed by Lillian, who will be doing the second reading, 1 Thessalonians 4, 13 to 18. So after the hymn, you will just come immediately after that. It is well with my soul. The song is in your programs, page 14.
soul. It is well. It is well with my soul. When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like tears billows roll, whatever my Lord thou hast taught me to say, it is well.
Psalms chapter 23, verse 1 to 6. The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
God Church, I will read the second reading from, and the Bible says, brothers, to be uninformed about those who sleep in death, so that you do not grieve like the rest of mankind who have no hope. For we believe.
For the reading of the Lord's word, we now invite Michelle to come and read the eulogy. Welcome, Michelle.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Michelle Serut. I am the last-born daughter of Honorable Serut, and I am honored to be reading the summary of his life. Life history of John Bomet Serut, former member of National Assembly, Mount Elgon constituency. Early life. Honorable John Bomet Serut was born in 1954 in Kapsambu village, Terem sublocation, Kapkaten location, Kopsire district, Bungoma County. He was the fifth-born child of the late Mzee Joram Diema Serut and the late Mama Elizabeth Chepkrenja. He was brother to Jeremiah Chepkoy, Lea Kogo, Anthony Karani, Robert, Francis Kwemoy, Henry Diema, and Francisca Chepkweny. Other siblings include Julia Chemos, Edward Kale, Moses Serut, Isaac Kosge, Nancy Chepsakit, Patricia Chepkesis, Nixon Kiplangat, and Bramwell Chongwon. Honorable Serut was circumcised in the year 1967, and he graduated into the Kip Nikiu HSETs according to Sabaot community traditions. I am also learning this now. Education. Honorable Serut joined Serem Primary School in 1962 and sat his CPE exams in 1969. He later joined Kapsokwony High School in 1970 and sat his O-level exams in 1973. While in high school, Honorable Serut was a student leader, an avid debater, and a very talented volleyballer. Honorable Serut joined Mount Kenya University in later life and graduated with a bachelor's degree in development studies. Graduated with a second class honors, upper division. He later enrolled for a master's degree in development studies and leadership in Mount Kenya University. He was a master's degree student, but was forced to defer his studies when he started becoming ill. Professional life. Upon completion of his O-levels, Honorable Serut taught as an untrained teacher in Terem Primary School up to 1979. In the year 1979, he was employed in the Ministry of Lands as a clerk, where he rose through the ranks to become a Registrar of Lands. In the year September 2002, he resigned and joined politics. Political life. Honorable John Serut resigned from the Ministry of Lands in September 2002 to try his hand in politics. He was first elected as Member of Parliament for Mount Elgon constituency in December 2002 on a KANU ticket. He served as an MP from 2002 to 2007. In December 2005, he was appointed as Assistant Minister for Planning and National Development by President Kibaki, a position he held up to December 2007. He unsuccessfully defended his seat on a PNU ticket in the 2007 elections. He then made a comeback to Parliament in 2013, where he was elected as an independent candidate. He served the people of Mount Elgon as their MP from 2013 to 2017. In 2017, he unsuccessfully defended the seat as an independent candidate. While in Parliament, Honorable Serut was an active member of the House Business, Labor, and Agriculture Committees. He also made significant contributions at the floor of the House. During his 10 years as MP for Mount Elgon constituency, Honorable Serut is credited with initiating a wide range of projects. Coffee factories in Chebich, Kiptaban, Mosindet, Sosio, power projects, health facilities in Kaboiwo, Kaborom, Chepkerer, Kaptama, Kaptalelio, etc. Purchase of school buses in Cheptais, Toroso, Kimabole, Kimobo, Kapkaten, Kapsokwony, Kongit, Kaptama, among others. Security projects in Kipieto, Kimobo, Sambocho, Chepkube, Kapsokwony, etc. Special programs projects in Nomoro, Serem, Kaimugul. Secondary schools in Kaboiwo, Chesito, Kaborom, Cheptonon, Masaek, just to mention but a few. He was a man of real development. Personal life. Honorable John Serut was married to the late Millicent Owor and later married Pamela Serut, and they were blessed, and they were blessed with 5 children, namely Max, Kolo, Brayo, Nyosh. Please nobody call me this name, Mishka. He had 3 grandchildren, Michaela, Aline, and Chelimo. Honorable Serut loved order and discipline. He was very particular on how things should be done. He was an ardent fan of AFC Leopards in the 80s and 90s. He used to take his family to attend all their games. He was also a big fan of Harambee Stars. Internationally, he was a huge fan of Bayern Munich and Germany. Honorable Serut also enjoyed watching athletics. He was an excellent volleyballer and was also good in drafts, chess, badminton, and darts. He loved reggae, gospel, rumba, and traditional Sabaot music. Honorable Serut loved reading, especially law, political science, religion, and current affairs. He loved his family and always gave them the best. Honorable Serut loved people and was known for his kindness and compassion. He was a member of Salvation Army and later the AIC Church, both in Nairobi and Mount Elgon. Illness. Honorable Serut was extremely fit and always enjoyed good health. Even at the age of 63 in 2017, he campaigned throughout Mount Elgon and traversed the entire constituency with relative ease. However, in late 2017, he could go down a hill and have difficulties coming back up. He was taken to the local hospital and he was diagnosed with anemia. He was treated and discharged. He carried on with life normally, but mid-2018, the same problem reemerged and with increased frequency. He was then put on treatment for iron deficiency anemia. Later during the year 2018, he began experiencing falls, and this spilled over to 2019. In July 2019, he began seeking specialized treatment in Nairobi. Several tests were conducted, but they all turned out to be negative. His heart, liver, kidneys, brain, etc. were all functioning normally. Towards the end of 2019, Honorable Serut's health worsened, and this puzzled the doctors as all his organs were functioning normally. He was admitted to KNH in December 2019, and that is when he was diagnosed with stage 3 multiple myeloma. MM is a type of blood cancer. He was treated and discharged and continued living life normally. In May 2020, he developed bleeding in his large intestine while in Mount Elgon and was rushed to Eldoret Hospital, and his blood level was at 3. Normal is between 12 and 18. He was admitted to ICU for 3 days and was later discharged after 7 days. In June 2021, he was diagnosed with pneumonia that had affected 92% of the lungs. He was admitted for 1 month but managed to make a full recovery. In September 2021, he again was admitted to ICU after going into a coma. He again made a full recovery after spending 5 nights in the ICU. Honorable Serut enjoyed 5 months of good health when on February 1st, 2022, he was admitted with a severe urinary tract infection that had gone to the bloodstream. On 5th February, the infection worsened and he was taken to ICU. On 8th February, he suffered a cardiac arrest while in ICU but was resuscitated after 4 minutes. He eventually succumbed to the infection in the early hours of 16th February 2022. This man was a real fighter, both in life and even when battling the health condition. We thank God for the fighting spirit and resilience that Honorable has shown throughout his life, and we are certain that he is in a better place. Go well, Honorable Serut. Your legacy will forever live in our hearts. Thank you.
Forever and ever, amen. We thank God, he's the giver of life. Let's appreciate Michelle. He's the giver of life. He ordains our days on earth, and when they are over, he calls us home, and we pray for comfort for the family. We are just about to get encouragement from the word of the Lord. I'll invite us to stand and do a hymn just to get ready for the word. Chakutumaini Sina, page 15 in your programs, page 15. Chakutumaini Sina. And after that, the senior pastor will come to invite the speaker.
Kwake Yesu nasimama, ndiye mwamba ni salama, ndiye mwamba ni salama, ndiye mwamba ni salama.
Okay, huo ndio wimbo, sasa tutaimba pamoja.
Cha kutumaini sina ila damu yake Yesu, Sina wema wa kutosha, dhambi zangu kuziosha. Kwake Yesu nasimama, ndiye mwamba ni salama, ndiye mwamba ni salama, ndiye mwamba ni kwake Yesu, kwake Yesu nasimama, ndiye mwamba ni salama, ndiye mwamba. Yesu ni mwamba, ndiye mwamba. Damu yake na sadaka, ninategemea daima, yote chini kisha Mwokozi ata kwake Yesu, kwake Yesu asimama, ndiye mwamba, ndiye mwamba, ndiye mwamba. Yesu ni mwamba, ndiye mwamba, ni njia yangu, njia ya iwe ndefu. Yeye hunipa wokovu, mawimbi yakinipiga, nguvu zake ni kwake Yesu. Ninasimama, ndiye mwamba, ndiye mwamba, ndiye mwamba, Yesu ni mwamba.
With them for a long time, and so normally it's hard to get him, but when this came, he said, I'll come for the family. And so we are very honored to have you. So let's appreciate our presiding bishop as he comes to bring God's word to us.
Thank you. To the family of John Serut, mama na watoto wako na wajukuu, waheshimiwa ambaye wako hapa, marafiki wa mheshimiwa Serut, mniruhusu ni wasalimu nyote katika jina la Bwana wetu Yesu Kristo. Hamjambo. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Kama vile Reverend amesema, mimi na mheshimiwa na mama na watoto wetu, ni hasa watoto ndio walitulete saiti pamoja, kwa maana walikuwa washirika wa karibu katika teams hapa AIC na Isambu. I'm sorry. Na Isambu is my local church now. AIC Milimani. So I came to know Serut very closely through our children, and we became close, and normally we could meet in Mount Elgon when he was when we were in meetings, when I was still active in the church work, and we became friends. So when Reverend and the family invited me to come and preside over this service, I said yes, because I cannot make to Mount Elgon because of my Samata commitments. So friends, family, accept my condolences from Mama and our family. All my family members say pole to you all. I'm so proud of Mheshimiwa Serut. He was one of those pioneer leaders who embraced Africa Inland Church in Mount Elgon. When I say leaders, I mean political leaders. He was one of them, plus Ndiema, Henry. I'm seeing Henry Ndiema. Is he his brother? I don't know. Not related. Oh, Ndiema is also a member of this church. He was Senator Ndiema of Kitale. Those were pioneer Sabaoth leaders. And of course, we have some pastors from Sabaoth community being led by none other than Reverend Mairori, who is the senior pastor here. And also in AIC fraternity, we have an assistant bishop from the community who is serving as the assistant bishop of Kitale area or diocese, whatever. And we are so proud of the many Christians who have embraced our church in Mount Elgon. So I stand here very, very proud, man, because I was leading this church some years back, about 2 years ago. I retired here and I went back home. So I know very well what was happening in the church, and I was very much involved. Today, I want us to zero in four areas in this short sermonette. It's not a long sermon. We'd like people to pay their tributes to the Moshimiwa family. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you that you have given us life to live today, to come here, to come and pay tribute to the family of Honorable Serut. Father, as we read your word and as we encourage each other, continue to bless this function until the end of it. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. I want us to talk about the state of the departed, our brother, John Serut. The state of the departed in the Bible is very clear. When we read the book of Psalm 116 verse 15, it says, God is pleased with the death or the passing on of his chosen person, a person who had, you know, accepted Christ as his personal savior. Kwa Kiswahili inasema inatamani sana mauti au kifo cha Mungu wake. Inatamani sana. Something very special. It's so special. It's so special to God because he has already gone to the other life. So inatamani sana majoni pa Mungu mauti ya mtu kama huyu. Revelation chapter 14 verse 13, it says, write, blessed are those who die in Christ. Blessed. Munajua ameparikiwa wale wanakufa ndani ya Kristo. Blessed are those who die in Christ. This man here, whom we see his picture, is blessed because he died in Christ. He started in Salvation Army and then later in AIC. Such people, the state is that they are blessed because they are with the Lord, their Maker. Blessed. And the reading which was read by our sister says, do not be ignorant. Do not be ignorant. Like others who do not know. We are more cleverer than the rest of the world, because we know those who die in Christ will rise up again with him. So Serut is not lost. Serut has just slept. He will rise with his Maker. We thank God for that. The state of the family here, their state at the moment is mourning. They're mourning. And I always tell people, do not come and tell people Don't cry. Don't do this. No, it is not that. You mourn when a departed person goes. People mourn when Moses died at Mount Nebo. We don't know where he was buried because he was buried by God. But the Israelites mourn him for 40 days. We mourn our departed ones. So the Serut family, it is not sin to mourn, but we should not be ignorant. We should not be ignorant like the rest of the people who do not know about Christ. The Bible says, mourn with those who mourn. Celebrate with those who celebrate. And that's the Bible. So it is given. When you feel like crying for your dad, just cry. There is no sin. Because he loved you, he stayed with you, the wife, you have stayed with him for many years. You cannot just ignore mourning. But we should be encouraged as a family that the maker of heaven and earth is with you. When Moses was taking the children of Israel from Egypt, he asked God, what am I going to tell them? Who are you? Tell me who you are. God told Moses, tell them I am. And then he repeated again. He said, go and tell them, I am, has sent me. I want to tell you, family of Serut, you are not alone. You are with Jehovah, who is and who is now here. He is God who is present, ever present help in time of need. He's just there. We will all depart today until the burial day, but you will remain as Serut's family and some few friends. Let me assure you of one thing. Jehovah I am is with you. He is with you. During the night, the day, he is with you. He was with the children of the Israelites all the way. When they reached the Red Sea, he was there. When they were in Mount Sinai, he was there. Jordan, he was there. When Jesus was crucified, he was there. You know, people thought God had left Jesus, but finally the whole earth quaked because God was there. Jehovah, I am, is with you, family of Serut. I want you, when you have a thought of Mze, just call on the name of the Lord, the ever-present helper. He will help you. In 2 Corinthians chapter number 1, verse 3 and 4, it says, may the Lord, the God of comfort, comfort you. We pray that he will continue to comfort you at this time. He will comfort you. The state of someone here who has not believed in Jesus Christ, I want to assure you, your name is not in the book of life. But thank God, you will not be thrown away. Jesus has come that you may have life and have it abundantly. There is no shortcut. It's Jesus. It's about Jesus only. He said, I am the way, the truth, and life. No one comes to the Father but by me. John 14:6. I am the way. So if you are here and you have not accepted Jesus Christ, he is the way. He is the only way. There is no other way. Your state, if you are not born again, is doomed to hell. But if you accept Christ as your personal Savior, you will join in the army of God. John 3:16, a verse which we are all quite conversant with. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever, and I repeat, whoever believes in him should have everlasting life. Whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Friends, the choice is yours. The choice is yours. No shortcut. Choices always have got consequences. If you choose not, you will perish in hell. But if you choose to believe, that whosoever believes in him should have everlasting life. In the Garden of Eden, God, Genesis chapter number 1, verse 28 and 29, and I want to zero in 29, which says, and God blessed them and gave them everything they needed. He told them, go, fill the earth. Have you ever thought, you people who are seated here today, has it ever come to your mind why we have trees, we have the birds, we have the oceans, we have air, we breathe, we have everything. We have the sun, we have the moon, we have day and night. Have you ever thought about it? It was all created for you and me. All these good things were created for you and me. The sunshine for you, oxygen. You saw recently when COVID came, we needed oxygen. God created oxygen for you. And then in verse 29, he says, God blessed them and said to them, be fruitful. 28, I mean. God blessed them. The state of our forefathers was a blessed state. They were blessed. But they chose the wrong side. Because in Genesis 2:17, God told them, well, I've given you all these things, but please don't touch the fruit of the middle of the garden, of the tree of the middle of the garden. Do not touch. But they chose to touch. And that is where we have this thing called death up to now. Choices have got consequences. But thank God, in Ephesians 1:3, the Bible says, blessed is God, our Father, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us through Jesus Christ. Now, as you are seated here, if you have accepted Jesus Christ as your Savior, you are already blessed. And even if you are here and you have not accepted Christ, still you are blessed. But you have to accept the blessing of God by accepting the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. You have to. You have to make that choice of accepting Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. So that we go back to where we were in the beginning. A blessed people. Finally, the state of us Christians. Most of us here, when I see most of you are Christians of different denominations. My appeal to you is be prepared, knowing that we are pilgrims. We are not staying here. John Serut is gone. We are going. Let's be prepared. This is something which people, especially the Christian fraternity, are not taking seriously. And I want you to take it seriously today, if you are a Christian from this church today. Let us be prepared. This is not our home. Let us choose life of prayer, life of reading God's word, life of going to church. I know most of you will be seeking some elective posts. I advise you, as a Christian, don't be so much engaged in civilian activities until you forget about church on Sunday. Just go to church on Sunday. Spend your time. If you are a Catholic, just go there. Spend 2 hours being with God. Jeshi la wakofu, Anglican, whatever church you come from. Spend 2 hours with God on a Sunday. Don't spend the whole day from morning to evening as if the whole world is ending today. This is not our home. Let us choose to honor God while we are still here. Some of us, we are endowed. God has given us money, properties, and so forth. Let us also bless the churches. Let us bless the churches. Let's give donations to the churches. Let us bless those who are angry. Let us bless others. There is a verse I love ever since I became a Christian. Do unto others what you would have them do to you. Let us bless some people. Especially us, if we have some food here. Most of us here have seen my friend. We come from Western Kenya. We have food. Just bless someone in Marsabit. Bless someone in Turkana, in West Pokot, and so forth. That is the Christian life. Let us leave selfishness. And when you go to church prepared with your offering, with your tithe, and so forth. To show the world that you are a pilgrim, this is not your home. If you involve yourself on things of this world, you will go like Serut has gone. Bishop Yago will go. We'll all go. But I thank God I'm spending my fortunes and everything in the kingdom. And I want you to do the same. Let us have time as Christians with our God. He has given us everything. He loves us. With those few remarks, I want to wish the family of Serut a blessed week as we take our Father home. May God give you the grace to stand. And may you know that one day you will see him. When David's son died, he said, "Bring the oil and food I eat. Because once he has died, I will not bring him back. But I will go where he has gone." So let's know that we will go to where Serut has gone. So let us encourage these words. Encourage each other with these words. May the Lord bless you and may the Lord bless all of us. Let's continue praying for the family. Ours is to pray for the family. Thank you, Pastor. God bless.
Thank you. Thank you. Let's appreciate our presiding bishop for sharing God's word. And I'll ask that as he's still there, the family, if you can join me at the altar. The family of our late brother would like to pray for the family, commit them before God. And since we have our presiding bishop, we will ask him to lead us in that prayer. So, Karibu Mama, if you can lead. Yes. Actually, let them come up. Just come up. Come up to the elder. Just come through here. Yes. I'll read Psalm 46, and then we'll ask the presiding bishop to pray for the family, as I ask my colleagues, the pastors, to join us on stage. Karibuni. Psalm 46 says, "God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, and the mountains quake with their surging. There is a river whose stream make glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells." I will go and read the last verse. It says, actually verses 10, it says, "Be still and know that I am God. I'll be exalted among the nations, and I'll be exalted in the earth. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress."
Amen. Tuombe. Mapasta tuwekelea au mikono namna hiyo. Baba wetu wa mbinguni, tunakushukuru Asante sana kwa kutupatia John Serut. Aliishi, akapata mke, wakapata watoto, wakapata familia, ata grandchildren, na wote wanasimama hapa mbele yetu, pamoja na ndugu yake. Tunakushukuru sana kwa maisha yake ambaye tuliishi pamoja. Ili kufurahisha umchukue yeye nyumbani. Kwa hivyo Mungu mbele yetu hapa, katika madhabahu hapa, ni familia. Hatuna la kuwapa hao familia. Ila somo hiyo ambaye tumesomewa, ya kwamba Mungu kwetu ni nguvu. Msaada unaoonekana tele wakati tunahitaji. Kwa hivyo uwe msaada wa hawa wakati huu wa majonzi. Wanasimama hapa, watakumbuka daddy for many days to come. But Lord, remind them that that was not the end. They will see them again. They will see him again. Kwa hivyo Mwenyezi Mungu, sisi kama wachungaji, tumesimama hapa kuwawekea mikono yetu na kusema Mungu awabariki, Mungu awalinde, Mungu awaongoze, Mungu awangalize uso wake kwenu kutoka sasa na awabatia amani. Kwa Yesu Kristo, Bwana wetu. Amen.
Asante sana. Asante sana. You can be seated, family. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Yes. Greet the presiding bishop, please. Please, yes. Thank you. Yes.
Yes, jamge.
Thank you. Asante. Mungu awabariki sana. Let's appreciate the family once again. We thank God for the family. May the Lord continue lifting you up. As the team will be leading us sing a hymn, we have an opportunity to worship God through giving an offering. So we have several ways we can do that, but today we will probably have two baskets in front. You can come and give, but also we have a pay bill number that will be shown, 809109. You just write offering that you can do. So I request Pastor Rachel to come and lead us as we all worship God in offering. Thank you.
We are going to sing the hymn in your programs, page 15, Nitabibu Wakaribu, as we give our offerings. Penny is here to help us with those who would like to bring their offerings in front, and the rest can use the pay bill number, which I believe is running on the screen. Nitabibu Wakaribu. Nitabibu Wakaribu. We can be upstanding as we sing and give unto the Lord is part of worship. We worship the Lord through what he has given us.
Tabibu wakaribu, tabibu wa ajabu, na rehema za daima, ni dawa ya kenjema. Imeni, imeni, maulai, sifa zake, sifa za Yesu Bwana, twekeli metukuka, jina lake Yesu, hatufai kuwa hai, wala hatutumai.
Imeni, imeni, malaika, sifa za Yesu Bwana, pwekeli metu.
kuka jina lake Yesu.
Dhambi pia
na hatia ametuchukulia. Twendeni na amani hata kwake mbinguni.
Imbeni,
imbeni malaika, sifa za Yesu Bwana pweke limetukuka jina la tukuka jina lake Yesu.
Asante, you can be seated.
Thank you. And as we sit, we will pray and thank God for the offerings. Let's pray. Eternal God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you that we can come before your presence and give our offerings. Would you bless your people as you bless us, as we continue in this service of remembering our brother, John Serut. We give you praise, for it's in Christ's name I pray. Amen. Amen. This will now transition to a time of tribute. And I want to say on the onset that I know everyone that is here has come here because in one way or another you have something to say to the family. And we want to recognize that. We recognize your presence and to say thank you. Given the opportunity, you would say a word or two to the family to condole them. But because of time, a few people will only have the time to do that. So let's accept that those who will speak on our behalf. And we all say amen to that. Number two, after the tributes from the family, I'm sure one or two leaders will speak. I want to encourage you, we are in church. And so today is about Mheshimiwa, just to encourage the family. Anything on political manifestos or all those that we do not encourage in church at all. So you just encourage the family and uplift them during this time. So for now, I'll call my brother Martin. Karibu, come and lead us in this session. Karibu sana.
Sorry. Thank you very much, Reverend Mairori, Senior Pastor, our presiding Bishop, retired Bishop Diego, the entire AIC leadership. We want to thank you for this opportunity. I'll be leading a very short session. My name is Martin Simotwa. I work for Independent Electoral and Boundaries Commission in Nairobi City County. And I come from Mount Elgon. Despite that, Serut was a friend and also a relative. The mom who is here is my mother-in-law. I marry her daughter, who has given me 5 children. One of them is a clinical or a medical officer, and I'm proud of that because they shared their genes, and those genes have made our family great. So thank you very much, all the guests who have come to pay pay tribute to our fallen leader. We want to welcome all of you. I know there are quite a number of us here who would wish to say one or two words, but might be because of time, we will not be able to say that. But just to mention, we are a pleasure to have Honorable Emmanuel Wangwe, who is the MP for Navakholo. Majority Whip is with us. We have Honorable Nick Salat, who was a great friend of the fallen leader. We have Honorable Dan Wanyama, the MP for Webuye West. We have Honorable Ferdinand Wanyonyi from Kwanza. We have Honorable Florence Mutua, woman rep from Busia. We also have the area MP, Honorable Kaponti, I think is there. But we have a great leader also of this country whom I could not believe, Honorable Mary Wambui from Odhaya. She's with us here, and I just talked to her. She said they were very great friends with the Honorable Serut. I've mentioned those words not because others are not also important, but everyone here is very important, and everyone here is highly recognized. So for the purposes of leading this session on tribute, I want to invite Honorable Kim Kung to help us, to lead us in this session. I want to believe that it will take the shortest time possible so that we can go to the next program. Mheshimiwa Kim Kung, karibu.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon, everybody. Mine is very simple. My name is Joachim Kung. Serut is my successor. I was a member of parliament for Mount Elgon, and he came after me before Kapondi. And I had the privilege of being a relative of Honorable Serut, separately, and a relative of his wife. So his wife is my sister-in-law. My brother was married to the sister, and he himself is my brother-in-law. His cousin was married to my sister. So they were very close. Today is not really a day of speeches, but before I invite the family, because the rest will announce the rest later, I would like to call upon the Member of Parliament for Mount Elgon, who will formally introduce his colleagues. I'm sure Simotwa did it, but he may not have known all those that were present. And maybe just call one of them to represent the rest, before I also call Honorable Salat, who was a very close friend of Honorable Serut, also say one or two things. Honorable Kaponde, please.
Presiding Bishop, retired AIC, the family of my late predecessor, it is my humble opportunity. I know this is a very difficult time for the family, to do a very brief ritual to introduce my colleagues who are present here. And following instructions from Honorable Kim, maybe give one to represent the rest. When they were doing introduction of colleagues who are present here, one was not introduced, our neighbor, Honorable John Waluke, seated behind with me. The rest were introduced. So what I want to say very briefly before the mourners, something very interesting with Mount Elgon politics is that most of us are related. Honorable Kim Kung, who was removed by the late, is related to the late Serut. I'm equally related to the late Serut through the wife, Pamela. The mother to Pamela is my aunt. So all of us, interestingly, are related in one way or the other. And I must say that in him we have lost a man, because for the last 20 years, the politics of Mount Elgon was between myself and the late John. To win, fail, and make a comeback is not very easy in politics. It's an indication of how strong somebody is. Personally, I used to cherish the competition, and we had a lot of respect for one another. As many people would say, the late would always say as it is. We used to have a lot of respect for one another, despite the many stories. John has left a very firm foundation for the family. That is my message to the family. The legacy that he has left is there for everybody to see. So family members, be strong that you have a very firm foundation that was built by your father and your husband. I don't want to say beyond that, but now take the opportunity to invite one member of parliament to represent us in the National Assembly, and going by the rank. And maybe before I do that, it is important that a former member of parliament, those former, can be represented by Mary Wambui, Mheshimiwa. You can come and eulogize, condole the family on behalf of former members of parliament. And then thereafter, going by seniority, we can have Emmanuel Wangwe, who is our chief whip, to represent members present here in the National Assembly. So Mheshimiwa Mary, and then you can come, brother. Thank you.
The bishop and the whole clergy and my colleague who are here and the people who came and the family of Serut. I just feel to come to say pole, because when I went to the parliament, we met with him, and we used to work with one committee called agriculture, and we used to go with him outside the country, and I found he loves the family most, because I remember God knows everything, because we cannot go to God without going to the grave. But I just want to tell the family, be strong, because your father loves you most than anything else. The reason I'm saying this, when you went with him outside, I was not aware Serut have girls, because I was not knowing the family. But I remember I used to go loud, the small girls, to buy clothes for her. And he was telling us to choose the best for her girls. I was with my daughter, Whitney, and she said, Pole. Me, my worker was to choose a dress, the best for the wife, whom I don't know. I don't know the size. It was a difficult job. That show that Serut having the family in her heart, in his heart. I just want to tell you, family. You know, we all going to go home and sleep. Even if we go love you so much and stay with you, we are going to feel asleep. But there's one person who cannot go to sleep. God. If you need anything, please ask your God to give you what you want. The wife of Serut, I just say, I know your husband have gone. But he have not gone. He have left the family we are seeing. So I just want to say for her, I know I was not knowing you. I was not knowing your family. But I know you through your husband. Let me repeat. When you went outside with my daughter, Serut was saying, I cannot go home without my daughter's clothes, whom we don't know. My daughter was to go loud to look the clothes for the daughter. Me, as a mother, I used to go loud to get a clothes for you, whom I don't know. That to say, he was having love. I just want to tell you, you know we will meet Serut up there. Because me, I know, when you leave this world, you go to your father who created you. You used to worry when the body leaving each other. But there's one thing, and that's why we are told by the bishop, we must love God. I am saved, and I was saved when I was young. And I was told my mother, there is nothing else in this world. Whether you get property, whether you get anything, even the pigs, one day you leave all those things, but you go to God. Be strong with God. Your husband, wherever he is, and I know he is with God, he wants to feel proud when you see you as a father, as a wife, that you have stood to the gap. The family, the children, love your mother. God said, love your mother, love your parent. And many years you are going to be here to you. Now you remember, your father is not there. Your mother is the husband and the wife. Whether he is your mother, you must know he is the owner of the house. Please respect him. Let us know the Serut we know when you are working with him to agriculture committee and the other committees. When I was in parliament, 11th parliament, the love he was having for you. I don't want to say much. I just came to say pole. My daughter said the pole. But now I'm happy I know you. And I know God is going to guide you. May God bless you. Yego is my friend for a long time. Thank you, Bishop. We are together with you. May God bless with my colleague, Wanyoni, and the rest, and Florence. May God also bless each and every who was here to say pole to my friend. And I know my friend. Go well. We'll meet you in heaven. May God bless you.
Before Honorable Wangwe pays his tribute, Honorable Moroto was very close Member of Parliament for Kabenguria, had not been introduced. Honorable Moroto is here with us, and you can now come to pay your tribute on behalf of Members of Parliament.
The church, led by Dr. Yego, the bishop, my colleagues, the family of my good friend, the late John Serut, Mama Pamela, and the family, and all the worshippers this afternoon. Good afternoon. God is good, and all the time, Asante Sana. On behalf of my family and that of the National Assembly and my colleagues, I wish to say pole sana to the family of my good friend John Serut. And before I proceed, Bishop, it's our norm, as we will be doing when we send him off, that my colleagues whom we served with, both the sitting and the former, please just stand up in honor of the late John Serut. Thank you so much, and may God rest his soul in peace. Thank you. Mine will be very brief, the way the church has directed us. I just want to say, Mama Pole. We served with John Serut, myself, in last parliament. I was with him. My wife, who is here with me, is a good friend to Mama Pamela. We've been following up the illness of Mzee. And the best time, when God calls on you, you accept the orders of God. And God has said, let Honorable John Serut rest in peace. He has harvested. And the best he has done is to take him from us and keep him in a holy book where he's resting. I believe my good friend is in peace with God, and let him rest in peace. Your husband was a hard-working man. And actually, whoever wrote the eulogy on how he has done the projects in the constituency should also look at what he did in the National Assembly. He was a no-nonsense man. He introduced me in the National Assembly on one, the respect to the speaker, respect to the leadership. I didn't know that he was preparing us for the future, but your husband gave us direction, especially as a member of the House Business Committee, where we get instructions on how the conduct of the House is going to be tomorrow. He's the one who told me, always read the order paper a day before, so that when you go on the floor, you do not get out of place. Instead, you understand what you are supposed to do tomorrow. Just the way the church would take us through the Sunday school and say, read what is expected tomorrow, so that when the bishop is talking, he takes half an hour, but you understand what the leadership is saying. That is the Serut, the man in the house. When you go to the audios, you will see how Honorable Serut contributed, especially the sugar issues of Western Kenya. It will be wrong, Bishop, for me to sit down without recognizing him as a member of Agriculture Committee, how he pushed for the sugar sector in Western Kenya. We salute him, and as he rests, we recognize him for that. Both Honorable Florence and Honorable Mary Wamboi, who are members of Agriculture Committee, they will attest to that. Mzee John Serut is resting, rich of information and knowledge on how to represent his people of Mount Elgon. Lastly, however tough the situation was, Honorable Serut could listen to you. And I want to recall one political scenario. When we were coming to Kapsokoni, myself in the company of the Deputy President, around 2014, and there was a road which had not been finished, the tarmacking of that road. And Honorable Serut was very keen and interested to see that that road is done, and it had not been done. He had to push the Deputy President to make sure that that road is put to conclude, to at least the contractor is on site before we come to Kapsokoni for a function in his constituency. That is how astute the Honorable Serut was, and he kept on telling us that, yes, if the government wants to visit you, that's the time to negotiate. Give what belongs to my people now, so that you come and address them. He was a protector of the people of Mount Elgon. I wish to thank the people of Mount Elgon for giving him the opportunity to serve, and also to help us to have met John Serut when he was alive. May God rest his soul in eternity. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Honorable Wangwe. Just a little correction, Honorable Kapondi. I was not removed by Honorable Serut. I was succeeded by Honorable Serut. Now, I would like to invite Honorable Nick Salat, nothing to do with politics, he's my Secretary General KANU, to say something and to, on behalf also of our chairman.
Bishop and the leadership ya kanisa yetu ya AIC family led by Pamela and the entire family na waombelezaji wenzangu, ningependa kuwasalimu kwa jina la Baba. Amjambo, amjambo tena. Kwa niaba ya familia yangu, kwa niaba ya familia yangu, niko hapa mbeleni yenu kwa siku hii ya leo kuja kuomboleza kwa rafiki yangu Mheshimiwa Serut. It's an honor, actually, it's a privilege that I've been given this chance to say something about my good friend Serut. It's been a while. For those of us who don't know, I served with him in the 9th Parliament with Honorable Serut, and we were good friends. And I can say very good friends. We also served, he was a shadow minister in the opposition. He was the shadow minister of agriculture, I was the shadow minister of the in the local government. So we were in cabinet with him. Bishop, najua siku hizi mimi pia nimeanza kusikia kabisa mambo ya Biblia. Mimi kwa kitabu ya Romans 12:9-16, musome hiyo, inasema, mourn with those who are mourning. Rejoice with those who are rejoicing. So I'm here to mourn a great friend. The irony of life. Na musicheze na maisha ya Mwenyezi Mungu. I want to tell a story. I didn't know, someday we were in parliament, close to the media tent. Then I was talking to Mheshimiwa Kimkun, who I'm told today, he's actually the one who is in charge of this preparation to give our friend a good send-off. Then in walks Serut. And then they met with Kimkun. My goodness, there was war. A very serious war, and Kimkun, you owe me because he was going to finish you. He did not see why Kimkun was doing, what was Kimkun doing in parliament na alikuwa amemalizana na mambo yake huko Mount Elgon. So I stood in between
This, I didn't know now, Kumba was in the middle of a feuding family issue here. I didn't know you have a family. There was a serious war. And I told, since he was my good friend, I told him, no, allow, you know, it's allowed for former members of parliament to be in parliament. So, nikakaa katikati. Because my friend Kim Kun here, you know Serut, by the way, let me tell you, a straight shooter. Kama akutaki, anakuambia akutaki. So he was our Sahele Tuko in battle. It was him and me. Many things I can say about this man, and I can tell you he was a good man. A very good man. He loved to dress well. He lived top notch. Ukiangalia kutoka head baka chini, ile suit ile saa sawa. Na mimi nataka nyinyi pia mukae namna hiyo. Kaa clean, sharp. Eh? Na alikuwa kwa chama ya baba na mama before he went independent. So mimi ni kusema tu, Pamela, your husband was a great friend. A man who was so, when he came to debating in parliament, he stood his ground. Go to the Hansa today in parliament. If you want to know how strong your dad was, visit the Kenyan library, the parliamentary library, and you will know what an astute debater he was. So I want to urge, musiwachi hiyo jina ya Serut iende. Mimi tu ni kusema ya kwamba kwa niaba ya mwenzetu ambaye ni mkubwa yangu Mheshimiwa Gideon Moi, who could not make it here today, ameniambia kwa niaba ya chama cha baba na mama, that is KANU, nilete rambirambi yake na sisi wengi wafuasi wa chama kwa hii siku ya leo. Ila tu ni kusema wacha mwenzetu apumzike. He's done his part. He came, he saw, and he conquered. Alifanya. Lakini kabla sijaketi bishop, allow me to say this. Leo, where I'm seated there, nimeona maajabu. I'm seated behind two couples there. I don't know them, and I think they are Serut family. The lady here, this is the lady here, the brown lady here, and the gentleman there. They must be married. Sijaona watu wanakunywa maji kwa chupa moja. Aki, no wamekunywa, wamemaliza chupa moja, they in the second bottle, na wanagawa. And then sahile wanaomba, bishop, wanashikana mkono. Yani wanashikana mkono. These two here. Unajua utuombe sisi wengine, when we last drop.
Thank you very much, Honorable Nick Salat. And you talked about that episode in Parliament. The late Honorable Serut and I talked afterwards, and we said we don't let the family know what has happened here. And we have kept that secret until today. You're a bad man. We want now to take this opportunity to invite the members of the family to each give to read their tributes. After that, then we can say our final announcements and then hand over to the church. Mama Pamela, we'll start with you. I think she's being represented. She can say her name.
It's okay. Wana sifiwe. Wageni wa John Serut. Tupunge kwa hewa, salamu za John Leo ni safari yake ya mwisho. Retired bishop. And the church as a whole. My name is Ibaros Chemtai Obwaka. I'm here to say something, but before I go there, I would like to say pole, my personal pole, and I came with my husband, Dr. Obwaka. Dr. Obwaka, can you please wave? Nataka kusema pole kwa rafiki yangu Pamela. She's my childhood friend. Pole kwa watoto wote. Na ningependa kuwahimiza vile pastor alisema, senior pastor, ya kuwa safari ikifika na ishafika. Na sisi wote tuko kwa hiyo msafara. Leo tumekuja hapa kwa ajili ya Mheshimiwa John Serut. Na tunakumbushwa ya kuwa kila mtu page yake ikifika, ikifunguliwa, siku yako ikifika, na tutaenda hivyo. Nataka kusema ni asante kwa sababu nataka kuongea kwa niaba ya Pamela, rafiki yangu, ya kuwa tungependa kurudisha shukrani sana. Mziko au msiba kama hii is so huge ya kuwa peke yako hawezi. Watu wote wamechangia kwa njia tofauti tofauti, wamemsaidia umama kusimama. Mwenyewe huwezi kufanya chochote. Na something else nataka kusema ni watu wa kanisa. Bishop, hata umetoka nyumbani, umeretire, umekuja kusimama na sisi, nataka kusema ni asante. Mungu awabariki wote, familia, marafiki na wabunge wenza wa John Serut. Najua mngepewa nafasi mnaweza kuongea mpaka kesho na isikwisha. But bado tuko na nafasi, hata nyumbani tuko na nafasi ya kusema. Anybody who wants to say something will have an opportunity. For me, I want to be say I'm very grateful to have been given this opportunity even to stand here and to be able to talk for Pamela. So mimi nimevaa viatu ya Pamela and I want to speak like should have spoken. My dear husband, my neighbor, friend, companion, confidant, and the love of my life, it's hard for me to believe that you are no longer here. Words cannot describe how this makes me feel. It is like a dream to me that you have passed on to the world, to the other world, and how I wish I could reverse what happened on 16th February. And bring you back to be with me. You are the best person I knew. Loving, caring, dependable, and most of all, the best husband and father to our children. For all the years we lived together, there is no single day that we lacked anything. You are the center of my world. You made me laugh, smile, from the beginning to the end. It scares me that you are gone forever and I have to take my car to a mechanic, organize insurance, and also run our home, something that I never did during our stay together. I remember our early life at Wema Chips and going to City Stadium to watch football between AFC and Gor Mahia. When chaos erupted and would go different directions, only to meet at home later in the evening. You were the best hubby, father, friend that I would ask for. Any time that I asked for money, your answer would be, "How much?" Did you hear that? Anybody heard that? How much? You never asked me what I wanted to do with the money or balance. If I wanted to travel abroad, your question would be how long I was going to be away. It goes without saying how you would introduce me to your friends. Or during meetings, you always referred to me as Mama Kelele or Mrembo Wangu. Some people viewed you as a harsh man, but to me and the children, you would not even hurt a fly. I remember one day when you went to KCB Serut Center. With the kind of jokes we had, some people mistook me for Mpango wa Kando. I will forever cherish the wonderful memories that we shared together. I remember in 2002, we went to the UK and disagreed. When you had to carry Michelle all over London because she believed that her feet were for wearing shoes. You referred to me as an outsider and Michelle as your own flesh and blood. Anytime you traveled, you would come back with two suitcases, yours and one full of clothes you have purchased for us. Your argument was that there'll come a time that you'll not have your family, so you better do your best for them now. I now understand that God spoke to you, that you leave me along the way. Forever you live in our heart and mind. Forever you live in my thoughts. With love always, with fond memories, I thank you. I'm grateful, God, for the lives we had and the time we spent together. I'll cherish my memories of you forever. Rest well, my beloved husband, Pamela, your wife. Thank you.
The eldest daughter, Maximila, to come and give her tribute. And Mheshimiwa, who's just walking? Ayub Sabula, you're recognized as Santa Son.
My name is Lillian. I'm a cousin to Max Miller, and she's not around now. I'm going to read a tribute. Dad, losing you has been the most difficult thing that I've had to go through in my life. But as I sit to write down what you meant to me, I cannot comprehend how to put down on paper in a few words. The 42 years of my life that I have spent with you, you are my first and constant teacher, my biggest critic, my greatest supporter, the one who picked me up grown up. You taught me self-belief, the value of family, and by watching you and mom working together, that anything in life is possible. Your love for us has always given us strength. You have held my hand through all of these years, and you will always be part of me. I love you, Dad, and may you rest in eternal peace. Max, daughter.
Upon Collins.
Asifiwe tena. God is good and all the time. My name is Collins, eldest son to the departed Mzee John Serut. I would like to call upon my wife maybe to do my tribute for me, since we live in an empowered world. Her name is Caroline Nunkipa. I think she'll do for me.
Good afternoon. I'm going to read the tribute. Dad, you've always been an essential part of my world. You took my hand from the time I was born, and just like a tree supports its branches, you provided love, strength, and support through the journey that has been my life. I can only hope to emulate your honesty, wisdom, strength, principle, and conviction to the truth. But most of all, I hope to emulate your love and commitment to family. As this, you always said, was the greatest treasure. Dad, battle bravely, and as you rest, your legacy is secured. Your spirit will live on through your children and grandchildren. For those we love don't go away, they live on through us every day. I love you. Kolo San.
Thank you. So praise the Lord. Unfortunately, I don't have a wife, so I'll have to read the tribute by myself. Now, my tribute is long. I don't want to read something very long. I'll just summarize it. 1954 is a long time ago. The colonial government was still in charge. Very few in this church were around. Uncle Kim Kung, maybe. Auntie Eva Rose. Walikuwa nacheza na mchanga hiyo wakati, because 1954 is a long time ago. And when you look at it with hindsight, of course, you know, living your, even if my dad died at 5,000 years, there is never a right time to say goodbye to someone. When he passed on, I always asked myself, was there more I would have done? Was there more conversations I would have had? But I encouraged myself and I said, especially when you're sick, we did everything that we could. So, 70s, 80s, 90s, you know, when I was in primary, we used to say the year 2000 will never reach, and now we are in 2022. So with that hindsight, I just want to thank God so much for the time that I spent with my dad. I always tell guys, at least ameniacha nikiwa mzee. I know my rights, I can stand up for myself. If he had left me earlier, of course it would have been more challenging than that. There are a few lessons I learned from him. And I think as children, we learn more from what we see than from what we are told. I saw him forgive. I know you guys, for most of you who don't know him well, my dad forgives. Hey, kuna vitu zingine alifanyiwa. And I still see those people at home. And I'm like, what? And I learned that heart of forgiveness. Hakuwa naeka vitu kwa roho. And I've learned that those guys who are wakali are usually the easiest people to deal with. Even lecturers in school, you'll note, those lecturers who are very rough on you are usually the easiest people to deal with. So my dad can very easily be misunderstood when you see him outside here talking very tough. But actually, he was even more approachable than my mom. Poor mom. My mom is the strict one. Utamona hapa lakini, we. My mom dole ataki mchezo. So, I want to thank, I saw my dad paying school fees for so many people. He literally educated like his whole family, plus a lot of random children. And I took note of that. He was very compassionate. Even when I moved around with him in the constituency and my siblings can attest, he could take someone's problem as if it's his own. And that made me, you know, I actually realized, well, this is actually the essence of life. Because at the end of the day, even Paul said, he who is stealing should stop stealing and work so that he can help others. That is exactly why we are here, to assist other people. And I saw him, you know, take people to school. I saw him help people, and that also helped me to take up the same model, and I realized that is the best thing. Now, I've seen a lot of my friends who were in the same church here. There is no friend of ours who's never come to our home.
our home is always open for everyone. And even people are shocked because my dad is a politician, and most politicians actually don't allow too many people to their homes, but our place is packed with everyone. My dad has never discriminated anyone. And all my friends who we've grown up with, there's nobody who's not been at home. There's nobody who's not slept at our house. They all know dad always welcomed them. And he also taught me how to treat women. And I saw him, how he treated my mother, how he treated my sisters and my grand and my nieces. And I think that is exactly how I should. Also, sikuile nitabatika nipate, like Collins, then I'll be able to do the same treatment. Then I can't leave this place without talking about discipline. Hey, my dad loved order. Ati uwache banana peel kwa gari hapo, wow, mtakosana ile amjaiona. My dad uvae torn socks. Kwanza he told me, as a man, if you cannot organize your socks, hakuna kitu unaweza organize dunia. He nearly sacked our farm manager. And moms, you remember, Benjamin was nearly sacked because he had put on torn socks. So my dad said, and he told, I'm going to fire you. Akasema pole mzee. So my dad always tells me, if you can't make your bed, if you can't put on socks that are orderly, then your life as a man cannot be orderly. And actually, when you look at it, there's a lot of sense to that. He was very disciplined. Honorable Nick has talked about how he loved dressing. My dad is very particular about dressing, and we had a lot of fights, me and Nyosh here. Anytime you dress up in a way that's not appealing to him, he could not. We tulipelekana sana. So, for me, I just learned, when I'm going to see my dad, this is how I'm supposed to dress. When you're going somewhere with him, this is how you're supposed to dress. Now, let me just wind up by talking about the time you were sick. It was rough. It was very, very rough. For those of you who've had cancer patients or had experience, you know how rough it is. If a day, not even a day, even if half a day passes without incidents, you thank God. I used to hate phone calls between, and all my friends know this, between 12 and 6, I used to hate phone calls at that point. In fact, my phone would ring and the first thing I would do is to pray and tell God, wa, kuna simu inaingia hapa. Na, just do something, isimu ikwe. And udapata simu. And then you're told, oh, Brian, nitumie credit ya so. I'm like, you're calling me at 2 to tell me to send you credit ya 100 bob. But you see, that was God intervening. Maybe that phone call was supposed to be bad news, but God changed it, ikakuwa mzuri. So it was rough. He was in ICU 3 times. And those of you who had patients in ICU, you know. Every time unaingia ICU first, there's a guard at the gate. You tell him, which bed are you going? I'm going to bed 8. Unasikia, wacha niangalia kama yuko. I'm like, sasa hii ni nini? And you know, it's so chaotic when you have someone in ICU. You see other guys coming, the first thing they do is the rosary. Yeah, Catholic. It's tough. But he has been in ICU 3 times. The first time you've seen in his eulogy, his blood level had dropped up to 3. His HB had gone up to 3. In fact, he had started gasping for air. But luckily, he was rushed to the ICU. And we saw how God saw my dad through ICU the first time. It was so tough. We were here in Nairobi. Mom and Michelle were in Mount Elgon. And that was the time when we had a lockdown. And you can imagine how rough it was. And his blood group is O negative. Those of you who know, O negative is a very rare blood group. And we thank God that he pulled through that one. Last year, September, again, he went to ICU. Second time. He stayed there for 5 days and he pulled through. He had 92% pneumonia. He pulled through. He had cardiac arrest and he pulled through. Imagine. Those are great miracles. He would have easily passed on the first time. But I saw God's hand through this whole ordeal. So even this last time when he left us, I look back with thanksgiving more than sorrow. Of course, we miss our father greatly, and I feel bad that he'll not even be there when I'm getting married. But what I'll encourage my family and our friends is, let's continue living our lives as if dad was here. because let's all make him proud. We knew the standards he had. We knew the passion he had towards education. Let's continue making him proud, and, you know, and may all glory and honor go back to our Lord. Thank you. That's my tribute.
Praise God. My name is Adams Kinyokye Serut, or Nyosh. I am the last born son, or the senior last born, as he used to refer to me. Before I read my tribute, I'd like to correct Brian on one thing. I have always been stylish, so Dad was correcting you. Mimi nimekuwa tu sawa sawa. So don't try and bring your rural dressing on to me, kindly. I'd like to thank you all for coming today. I'll read my tribute. My tribute was titled, The Warrior Has Slept. What can I say about a man so many have said so much about? All I can say is what you meant to me, my hero, my problem solver, my refuge, the man I aspire to be. I am feeling so lost as I write this. You're not here to correct my English. Not here to tell me to be proper, not here to be my dad. I know you're no longer in pain, but part of you still wants part of me still wants you here, still needs you to guide me, still needs you to be my dad. I wish I expressed my love more when you were alive. I wish I gave you your flowers when you could still smell them. I don't know what I'll do without you, Dad, if I'm even a quarter of the man that you are, I would have done great in my life. Thank you for being who you are, and I can't wait to see you in the afterlife. I promise to take care of Mom, Max, Kolo, Brayo, Mish, Michaela, Aline, and Jelimo. I love you, Dad. Rest easy. P.S. I made sure they buried you in a designer suit like the boss you are. I think the people who have spoken before me have spoken basically everything about the man he was. And at the risk of sounding repetitive, he basically is everything I've ever wanted to be. His discipline, his charisma, his intelligence are things that I have always been proud of. His pride for his family are things that I always want to be associated with. So I'd like to thank you all for coming today. I'd like to recognize a very special group of people, and if the team from Kenjen could kindly rise, I'd just like for you to recognize them, because they're my colleagues and they have stood with me from the start. My two bosses during my dad's illness were Janet Muhoro and Lillian Wedaka. They have been very supportive. Anytime I needed time off, anytime I needed to travel, they were always supportive, and I thank you very much. For the rest of my friends and everybody who is here, may God bless you, and have a nice day.
Hello, I'm back. Hopefully this time Kiingereza haitanikanganya tena. So, as you know, my name is Michelle Serut, my father's last born, his little baby. And I think writing this was the hardest thing, and the words still didn't seem enough. But here it goes. Dad, daddy, father of mine, these are words you'll never hear me say again. It still doesn't feel real. My last words to you were passed on by Mom because I didn't have the strength to see you while you suffered. I love you and I miss you. Those are the words you went away with. My dad was the best dad. I remember hearing stories about how people would cower in fear when they had their father's car pull up. But for me, I'd always run outside and give him a hug because I wanted to be the one that welcomed him home. I'd give him a hug every night and he'd kiss both my cheeks. I wish I'd done that more in the last few years, but growing up. I'll never forget the pride my father had every time he introduced me to his friends. He would always call me Mkora wake and say I got my brains from him. In my 23 years, I made him proud every day, and I will forever hold on to that. I will always remember you insisting that I speak during your rallies. You wanted the people you served to know me, and you helped me build my confidence. I'll also miss introducing my friends to you, Dad. You always made them feel so welcome and at home. You became their dad as well, and I couldn't be more thankful. Mom always complains about how many shoes I buy. It's your fault. When I was four, I wanted you to carry me all the time, and when you asked me what my legs were for, I said they were for wearing shoes. I still think that's a valid point. You didn't question it. Now that I'm too old to be carried, my legs still have to be for wearing shoes, one way or another. Daddy, thank you for all the lessons you instilled in me. Thank you for teaching me that I should never allow people to put me down. Thank you for teaching me how to drive and helping me with my math homework. Thank you for giving me space to grow and blossom. Thank you for loving me fiercely and showing me how a husband should love a wife. Thank you for working hard and sacrificing for us. Thank you for being you. I have so much I want to say to you, Daddy, but it seems we've run out of time. I will leave you with these words again. I love you and I miss you. Your little Mkora.
Good afternoon, I'm Makela Serut. Babu, I'm still struggling with coming to terms with the fact that you're actually gone. I can't seem to be able to put my feelings into words. Throughout my 16 years of life, you've been here for me. You've been my encouragement and you have inspired me. You've been my best friend and I've taken pride in being Babu's baby. I've learned so much from you. I can recall the days when we used to go for car rides together and when we used to do Sudoku and crosswords while listening to music in the office. You're one of the strongest men I've ever known and you've fought your battles bravely. I thank God for letting you be a part of my life, however short the time we spent together was. And I thank you for being the best grandfather I could ask for. I will love and miss you forever.
Friend that was supposed to read her tribute, amewaogopa kidogo, ni kama mnakaa kumshtua. But I will read the tribute for the other two grandchildren who are a bit young. Babu, we love you so much and we feel sad that you will not be around to watch us grow up. We thank God for the little time we spent with you. We promise to make you proud and you will always live in our little hearts. Aline and Chelimo.
Let's appreciate the family for sharing their tributes with us. May the Lord continue strengthening you and being with you during this time. The Seruts were members of this church when they are here in Nairobi. And so with us today, we have four pastors of AIC Milimani. All of if you could stand so that we do a formal introduction. We have Pastor Rachel, who is in charge of our children and women ministry. Let's appreciate her. We have Pastor Kip, who is in charge of our teens. Let's appreciate him. And then Pastor Youth, who is in charge of our youth. The other pastors are not with us. They are out, and so they send their condolences. But on behalf of the rest, let me welcome Dr. Victor Boyo, who is also a neighbor on the other side. He's the chair of our missions committee, to just say a word of pole on behalf of the church. Karibu, Daktari. Thank you, Reverend Bishop Emeritus, our pastors, the family of the late Serut, distinguished guests, mamibi na mabwana na wasalimu katika jina la Yesu wa mjambo. Bwana Yesu wasifiwe, praise the Lord again. As you've heard, my name is Dr. Victor Boyo. I serve here AIC Milimani Missions Committee. But again, I am a neighbor to the Seruts. And before just I say a word on behalf of the church, the first time I had a one-on-one encounter with the late Serut, he visited me with Mama in school. I was in high school. That is Lenana School, back in 2002. I didn't know them quite well. When I went back home, I asked Baba, Serut visited me. Are we related? He told me in our local dialect, Kiomji ndospoik. Yani wazazi wao walikuwa wanakula pamoja. And the last time we met with this family again, of course we have had a journey, was in 2019 when I was graduating with my doctorate degree. Their daughter was also graduating. And we took a photo, we had a good time. And I remember they told me, mentor this young girl also to do a PhD. I hope we'll continue that story. However, there's so much that can be said today. But as a church, AIC Milimani, we want to pray that God will comfort you. God will give you grace. God will walk with you. And in all this, you will see the faithfulness of God. We have been in a journey praying together. I remember we pray here at times when I'm at home. We could partner with Pastor Zacchaeus, visit Mama, and we pray together. But here we are today. We are saying God is still enthroned. On behalf of this sanctuary, the leadership, members, the entire family of Serut, we are saying, Pole, we'll keep working together with you. We'll keep praying for you. And one thing we are sure and we are certain of is that everlasting Father, eternal God, God of all comfort, will comfort all of you for the glory of his name. God bless you and God do you good. Thank you. Thank you very much, Daktari. Now I began before we did the tributes to say I know each one of you that is here would have loved to say something. So on behalf of Mama and the family, we greatly, greatly appreciate you. You didn't get a chance to speak, but your presence here speaks a lot. So asanteni sana kwa hiyo. Now, while I'll be standing here, I want to invite the person that will give a vote of thanks and announcements, just combined together, if we can do that. Is it Chimote? Karibu. If we can do that, and then we will have the last prayer together. So, karibuni.
Thank you so much, Reverend Mairori, Bishop Emeritus, Dr. Yego, the church, and everybody who's here. First, allow me to have this privilege to make an announcement. Tomorrow morning, the body shall depart, leaving our home to JKA at 7 a.m. The flight will leave JKA at noon, arrive in Eldoret at around 2:30. Thereafter, the procession will lead to Mount Elgon via Webuye, Kamkuyua, Kaptama, Kapsokwony, and at home Kimobo. It will lie in his home for night vigil And then on Friday, there will be a small service at home where we will allow the public to view the body, and then the church will have a session, and then family speeches. On Saturday, the body will move to Kapsokwany primarily for a funeral service that will, we hope to end by 3 p.m., then it will be taken home for interment at around 4, 5. So that's the announcement I will want to make. On behalf of the committee, first we want to thank God for the life of Honorable J.B. Serut. We thank the church for being with the family. We thank the family for giving us and for allowing him to be with the people of Mount Elgon. It was not easy, but through his grace, he's been there twice as a member of parliament, and he's departed. We thank the family for allowing him to be with that. We also take the opportunity to thank the hospital, especially Nairobi Hospital and Eldoret Hospital, who took care of him. The doctors, they tried their best, but it was his time that God had given us, and he had to go. We thank the many people who came to condole with the family through prayers, the leaders who came, the committee members, friends of the family, especially of the sons and daughters. You've seen their workmates who are here. We thank you for your enormous contribution, support, prayers, and everything. Importantly also, I want to take this opportunity to thank the leaders from Mount Elgon, former elected leaders, current leaders, for showing leadership at this time. I'm sure the image that has always been seen of Mount Elgon, people are scared that maybe you can go there and there will be chaos. I want to assure you that seeing our leaders stand here, we are going to ask and request our supporters that it was just politics. It was never that personal. You've seen Joe is here leading. My friend Kapondi is here. I can attest he's the one who introduced me to Serut. Despite our political differences, we are always united. So we want to request you that when you come to Mount Elgon, there will be peace, there will be no chaos, and we'll give our friend, our father, our political father, our leader, a befitting send-off. Above all, you are welcome home, continue praying the family, and I couldn't find to thank each and everyone, but by this opportunity, feel appreciated for your prayers, contribution, support, and attendance. Karibuni sana nyote Mount Elgon. Asante. My name is Evans Kiproti Chemwote. Asante.
Let's appreciate Brian. Thank you very much. We appreciate Evans. And now I was actually going to call Brian to come on behalf of the family to give a vote of thanks. Karibu.
So, bonus fio tena. Now, Honorable Evans has given most of the vote of thanks, but as a family, there are just a few additions I want to make. First, I want to thank God. Manze, you know, seeing someone through from being small, being born, to get to 67, and he was to turn 68 in May, is a lot. So we thank God for sustaining him throughout this time, up to the point he's gotten. He's been through a lot in life, but God has seen him through up to this point. We thank God for that. The 10 years he served in Parliament, we thank God for the 25 years he served in lands, and also for the time that he has spent with us. We are grateful. Secondly, I want to thank my mother so much, our mother. Hey, the work that she did. You know, her life stopped. From 2019, her life stopped. She's an employee of Bungoma County, but she didn't step into the office from December 2020 up to date. She stopped her life to take care of our father. And it's so easy to let that go down. She even leaving the house. Yeah, thank you for that clap. Leaving the house was a luxury. And for those of you who've cared for patients, you know how difficult it is. And we watched her. There are times she could call us at 2 in the morning, come to the bedroom, Mzee is not feeling well, come at this time. And she has gone through so much. And we want to thank God for her. For my siblings, they have stuck by Mzee so much. And even for them, it every day was difficult. They were always available. Some, like Collins, have their own families, but they took their time to come back. Collins, Caro, Nyosh, Michelle, Max, Michaela, and the immediate family took so much time and invested so much in Dad. So I want to say thank you so much for them. And I pray that we'll continue supporting each other the way we have been supporting each other. Thank you so much to Uncle Kim Kung. God bless you so much. Uncle Kim Kung has taken his time. He's been the chairman of the committee. He's worked very hard. And we, as a family, want to say a special thank you to you, Auntie Eva Rose. God has seen what you have done, and you have stood by Mom, along with Dr. Obwaka. We want to say thank you so much. For all our leaders, Honorable Kapondi, thank you so much. It's the first time we're actually meeting you. Thank you so much for what you've done. You've been present every single time. Honorable Evans, we also want to say thank you. You have been there full time with us. We want to give thanks as a family. Honorable Wangwe, the governor, Governor Wangamati, Speaker Lusaka, our senator, Moses Wetangula, our women rep, and all the leaders. There are so many leaders who have come. Yes, thank you. You see, there are so many people who have helped to say that it's easy to even some let some go. For all MPs who have come and our former MPs, we want to say thank you so much. Yes, Honorable Mary Wambui, Dad told me you're a great friend. That one I can attest to. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you, Honorable Wanyama, for coming. You came for the fundraiser yesterday. We say thank you so much as a family. Plus all our MPs, the Deputy President, thank you so much in absentia. He's away in America. He sent his contribution. Honorable Oscar Sudi, Honorable, you see so many people have helped until some I have forgotten. But if I've not mentioned your name amongst the political leadership, please forgive me. But thank you so much for coming. And thank you for your contributions, and thank you for your time. Those who are going to be able to join us for the burial on Saturday, we say thank you so much. Mama Mlai, which is an organization where my mom is. It's a group of women who've come together. They have really supported mom and us. NALSA, this is spouses of members of parliament. Also, we want to say thank you so much for your contribution. We say thank you to the church, Bishop Yego. Bishop, you have been a father to me, you know, for how many years? For over 20 years. And you've always welcomed me in your home, and my siblings, and you, and Kina Andrew. Yes, and Andrew, and David, and our good friends, thank you so much. Thank you so much, Reverend Mairori. Thank you for the friendship. You came to hospital to see Dad also, I think sometime last year. Thank you, Reverend Luke, for your contribution. Yes, unajua kenye umefanya. And all our pastors who have been with us, Pastor Rachel, and all our pastors, we want to say thank you so much. Now, there's one person I want to give special recognition. And before I give him, I also want to give thanks to those who've come home to wash dishes. You know, it's so easy to look at the people who've contributed and forget there are people in the kitchen who stand there for 7, 8, 10 hours. Until I told one lady that if your hands could dissolve, they would have dissolved a long time ago. Because they wash dishes, they clean, they cook, and it's very easy for them not to go unrecognized. So I thank you. But there's one person in particular I want to thank, and I would like him to join me here, please. Alex. Tafadhali kuja mbele. Kindly, please come. Aleki, Alexander, Director, Abdi, all those names he was given. Now, what this man has done to Dad, we cannot even describe. Alex to a mask, what on dark kukuona? Yes. This was our father's caregiver. And for the last 3 years, he has been the one who has done, for those of you who've cared for patients, again, I'll go back to that. You know, there comes a time where even tasks that you should be able to do for yourself, you cannot. Alex, Dad could be admitted for 1 month. He goes to Nairobi Hospital and lives with him there. He has lived with Mzee in hospital. You know, with cancer, you can be admitted anytime. Eldoret Hospital, Nairobi Hospital, he has lived with him. He stayed with Dad from morning to evening. Morning to evening, spent the night there. The next day, morning to evening, his life completely came to a standstill. And it's so easy to underrate what he has done. So as a family, we don't even know what to do for him. Because even my dad used to tell me, Brian Nikipona, I don't know what I'm going to do for Alex. So we want to say thank you so much, Alex, for the work that he's done for Dad. He's lived with him in hospital. He has been a caregiver for the last 3 years, and he does it in a raw safi. No grumbling, no complaining, no murmuring, until even the doctors and the nurses at Nairobi Hospital were in shock. He's even well known there, anasalimiona madaktari wote, because of spending time. For those guys who've slept in hospital, you know how boring a hospital is. So to live there for 1 month, Mzee could cough in the night, he's already awake. Mzee could turn, he's already awake. So we thank God so much for Alex. Alex is our family, and we have no words, but God has seen what you have done, and God is going to bless you. So thank you so much. Thank you, Alex. Thank you for our friends, our colleagues from Kenjen who've come on behalf of Adams, those from KRA. I've even seen people I was in primary school with all those years ago. We want to say thank you. Those who are in high school together, Kama Rotich, Ukonyuma, thank you so much. If I've not mentioned you, please forgive me. It's because so many people have helped. And you know, I love you know, say easy, akili meja. There's so much you're thinking of. If I've not mentioned you, I want to say thank you so much as a family. God bless you. After this, we are going home. Please, all of you, you are welcome. Uko kuna chai. Kuna chai nyingi sana nyumbani. Kuna mandazi. Kuna samosa. Please, all of you, you are welcome to come and give us support. Tomorrow at Lifinro Home, you're all welcome in the morning. And as Honorable Evans has told you, please, you're all welcome to Mount Elgon. Mount Elgon is very peaceful. Forget about what you see in the media. You come there, and may God bless all of you richly. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Brian, and thank you, family. All right, we've come to the end of our memorial service. I know many would have spoken. We have an elder, Boyo, just stand. We recognize you, Peter Boyo, just stand. Peter, let's appreciate Mzee Peter Boyo. Kina Dennis Chabitbe, though you're younger, karibu sana. Na wale wengine wote. You would have shared something, but we say thank you. Would like to all stand. We want to bring our service to the end. If we can sing, go back to the song, Mwamba Wenye Imara, Rock of Ages, just for the family. If it is okay, I will change what is done. Pastor Rachel, if you can lead us in that, one or two stanzas. And then we'll invite our presiding bishop to give us the words of benediction. After that, we will have the recession. All right.
Mwamba wenye imara, kwako nitajificha, maji hayo na damu yaliyotoka humu unisafi na dhambi, unifanya mshindi kwa kazi zote pia sitimizi.
si sheria, nijapo fanya bidii, nikilia na kudhi, hayaishi makosa, niwe wa kuokoa.
Remain standing. Basi Mungu wa amani aliyemleta tena kutoka kwa wafu mchungaji mkuu wa kondoo kwa damu ya agano ya milele, yeye Bwana wetu Yesu Kristo awafanye ninyi nyumba ya Serut kuwa wakamilifu katika kila tendo njema, mpate kuyafanya mapenzi yake na yale naye akifanya ndani yenu lipendesalo mbele zake, kwa Yesu Kristo utukufu una yeye milele na milele. Amina. Tuseme neema pamoja. The grace, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
We remain standing. The presiding bishop and the pastors will be in front, and then the family will follow so that we can we finished our service. We'll follow in that order, but let's remain standing and wait. Let's wait as the presiding bishop leads us in the reception. Thank you.
Bwana ni chungaji wangu, sitapungukiwa kitu. Ulaza kwenye majani mabichi, unyongoza kwa njia za haki. Hakika wema nazo fadhili zitanifuata mimi, nitaka nyumbani mwa Bwana siku zote za maisha yangu. Unihuisha nafsi yangu, unongoza kwa njia za haki. Nipitapo bondeni mwa mauti, sitaogopa, wewe unami. Hakika wema nazo fadhili zitanifuata mimi, nitaka nyumbani mwa Bwana siku zote za maisha yangu. Gogo lako na fimbo yako vitani fariji mimi, waanda meza mbele ya angu machoni pa watesi wangu. Hakika wema nazo fadhili zitanifuata mimi, nitaka nyumbani mwa Bwana siku zote za maisha.